So today we will start the chapter, second chapter of economics, people as a resource. People as a resource. People as a resource. People, total population of a country is the asset of the country. Asset. They are the assets of country. People, the total population of a country.
Am I audible?
Mitansh, am I audible? Mitansh, okay. So people of a country, the total population of a country is generally as the asset of that particular country, the property of the country. Total population has constitutes the total population is generally constitutes the asset, the property of a country. They are not the liabilities. Liability means burden. Liability means burden. They are not as the liabilities. They are the assets because they contributing in economy. People are contributing in economy. Contributing in economy. People are generally contributing in economy with production of goods and services. Doctors, engineers, teachers, these are the services. So they generally contribute in economy with production of goods and services. With production of goods and services, they contribute in economy. They contribute in economy. Resource means resource, any substance which can fulfill the human needs is a resource. Which can fulfill the human needs are resource. So when population is productive for a country is a resource. When total population is productive for a nation, productive for a country, how is this productive? By production of goods and services. By the production of crops in agriculture, farmer becomes as a productive for the nation. Industrialist, which has giving the jobs to the unemployed, this is as a productive for the nation. Clear? People in working in a banks, insurance services, marketing, transport, trade, communication, health, education, all these are the services. So when the people are engaged in such sectors, they are providing the services in economy. They are productive for the nation. So when a population is productive for the nation is considered, is known as the, that is known as the, that is known as the productive for the nation, that is known as the resource. People are considered as a resource. So is that clear, the name of a chapter? People, they are generally as a considered as a resource because they contributing in economy in a form of production of goods and services. In a form of production of goods and services, they contributes in economy. They contributes in economy. That's why the people are resources. People are resources. People are generally considered as the resources. Clear? They are generally considered as a resources. In this chapter, people as a resource, we will basically learn about, we will learn about, in this chapter, we will learn about the activities, number of activities which are associated in economies. There are two categories of activities are there. There are generally two categories of activities generally lies in economy, in Indian economy. One as the economic activities, and second as a non-economic activities. non-economic. Difference as a, which we will discuss later, the economic, which helps to generate income. It helps to generate income. And activities which do not generate income are the non-economic activity. They are the non-economic activities. Example, Anshya Agarwal, she taught her younger sister. Younger sister is a non-economic activity because under such circumstances, Anshya's sister, it doesn't paid any money, any not given as any kind of a goods or a money to Anshya Agarwal. That's why it is a non-economic activities. Your mothers, which are preparing food for you, it's a non-economic activities. Understood? And economic activities are broadly categorized into three categories: primary, secondary, and tertiary. Primary, secondary, and tertiary activities. Tertiary activities. So one aspect related with this chapter, people as a resource, three kinds of economic activities, which we will discuss in later. Second, qualities of population. Qualities of population. So generally the population has consisting the two qualities, health and education, two services which contributes to improve the quality of population, which directly contributes in to improve the quality of population. One as a health and education. So Indian government, how does it contributes in improving this health and education? We will discuss in this chapter. And third aspect, unemployment. So what is the unemployment and various forms, and how can we solve the problem of unemployment? We will discuss in this chapter. Clear? This is as a brief description regarding the people as a resource. People as a resource. Understood, everybody? So let's start this chapter. People as a resource. People as a resource. People as a resource. So people, total population of a country, they are productive for economy, productive for country by production of goods and services. But it doesn't mean that you kids, students are not the liabilities. No doubt you are not producing at present. At present you are not producing in economy because you are attaining education. You are the assets of our country. Students are the assets of our country. Why? Because after completion of an education or professional degrees, you will productive for the nation. You will join different professions. Then you will contributing in economy. You are the assets. You are the resources. Such resources which will be used in future. And a population which has generally lies above of 60 years, they are not as the liabilities. These are not the burden because they already contributes in economy. If presently they are not producing, people which are lies under the age group of 60 plus, which are generally retired from their services, from their works. If we will consider them as the liability or a burden, under such circumstances, there will be no security of a life in India. People, they will not prefer to live in such countries where such people, it will be considered as a burden in economy. Because already they worked in their lifespan of 30 to 35 years for production. Liabilities are those which do not produce anything throughout their life. Such kind of a population, which is not healthy, which is a mentally not stable, for such kind of individuals, they are considered as a liability, which are not contributing in economy. They are the liabilities. They are the burden. Clear? They are the burden. On a world economies, when we're talking about the other economies of the world, what other countries of the world, their study, there is one study related with the world countries given by the World Bank, which was given by the World Bank. World Bank categorized, it classified the world economies, the different countries of the world, into three categories. First, developed countries. Second, developing countries. Third, underdeveloped countries. So that classification of a world economy is given by the World Bank based upon a concept or a objective of or idea of per capita income. This is also known as average income. This is also known as average income. Per capita income means average income earned by all the individuals in economy is average income or per capita income. How can we calculate? We can calculate the average income by total income earned from primary activities, secondary activities, and tertiary activities divided by total population, through which we can calculate the per capita income. We can generally calculate per capita income as total income earned from primary sector, means farmer producer crop, miner done their work in a mining sites. Clear? So the primary activities, secondary activities, and tertiary activities divided by total population, through which we can calculate the per capita income. There are a large number of people which generally earned in millions, in billions, but there is also a large section of population which generally not produce anything, means they are not having the regular source of income. They are generally under poverty. Poverty means when a person unable to complete their basic needs. It constitutes the 27% of total population. So due to the 27% of such population, which do not have the regular jobs, they are generally responsible for the low per capita income in India. The per capita income of India is 27,000 annually. Jo average income India ke andar hai, wo 27% hai because of such 27% people which lies under poverty. Yes, Dhiren.
Sir, please repeat, what is per capita income?
Wait. Yes, repeat.
Sir, please repeat, what is per capita income?
Per capita income is the average income earned by all the individuals. Average figure. Average income earned by all the individuals. So you can understand from this as there are 47 students in a 9th A standard. 47 students in a 9th A standard. All are schooling. Classes who are 30% of students which scored as a 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10. And rest of the students, they scored in between of a 4 to 9. 4 marks to 9. When we sum up the all the marks scored by all the individuals, those individuals which attended the test, divided by the total number of appeared students through which we can calculate the average. Same as total income which earned from primary sector, primary activities, secondary activities, and tertiary activities, divided by total population. Divided by total population is per capita income. So this criteria used by the World Bank to classify the world economies, in which developed, when we're talking about the developed, America is a developed country because poverty has not existed on such countries. US, England, Canada.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, 27% is for whole India.
Whole India.
Which do not contribute.
People under poverty. Wo population which can't complete their basic needs. People which can't afford as a two meals in a day. Two meals.
Okay,
sir. Mein do time ka khana plus food, shelter, clothing. Food, shelter, clothing are the basic needs of population which can't, which unable to complete their basic needs are under poverty. Agar aapke mind mein ye aa raha hai, how can they survive? These people are generally surviving on a government supportive schemes. Different schemes are initiated by the government of India. For example, Antyodaya Ann Yojana. This is one of the schemes in India which has given the cheap food grains at a cheaper rates. Generally in market, 25 rupees as a per kg wheat selling in a market. But through the government ration shops, 2 rupees per kg wheat, 3 rupees rice and 20 rupees pulses. On such rates, such materials are providing to the sections, only such sections which are under poverty. Clear? So come towards here. On the basis of a per capita income, World Bank divided world economies as developed economies, developing economies, and underdeveloped economies. So developed economies are those where per capita income is more than 4 lakhs. So such countries where the annual per capita income is 4 lakh rupees, more than 4 lakh rupees, they are developed economies. USA, United States of America, Canada, England, Russia, France, all these, Japan are the developed economies. They are the developed economies. Clear? Developing economies, those economies which are having as a per capita income in between of, yes, there is, which are having as a per capita income in between of 35,000 to 4 lakhs. So such countries where per capita income is annually 35,000 to 4 lakhs are the developing economies. Means they are improving their standards. They are improving. They overcome their problems of unemployment, poverty. Such kind of problems are tried to sort out by the such economies. Clear? And third are the economies which are basically dependent on others, which having as a less than 35,000 per capita income. 35,000 per capita income are the underdeveloped economies. As per the World Bank's classification, India in underdeveloped economies. If we use the criteria only as a per capita income. Clear? Is that clear? But there is another classification is there, which states that if we use the health and education, health and education as the indicators to set to check the world economies under which India lies in developing. India lies in developing. No doubt, per capita income is low in our country, but health status and education facilities are much better. Health status, cheaper health facilities, and literacy. Rate of literacy in our country is better. Rate of literacy in our country is better. This report was given by the HDI, Human Development Index. HDI, Human Development Index. Clear? So in presently, the India is a developing country. If we following as a that classification of a HDI, because health facilities in our country is a much better comparatively the independence or the level of a literacy. Literacy rate in our country. Yes, Janvi. Jia Janvi.
Sir, please repeat per capita income of underdeveloped countries.
Repeat.
Sir, please repeat per capita income of underdeveloped countries.
Underdeveloped as less than 35,000. Less than 35,000 if we use that criteria only. But mostly this classification has not used by the economies. Reason, because uneven distribution of natural resources. Natural resources are not equally distributed. Agar jin countries ke andar resources hi nahi hai, the natural resources are not there. It directly affects the types of the activities. Types of activities, economic activities are influenced by them. That's why such economies are lagging behind. For example, African countries. When you are talking about the African countries, where the agriculture is not possible. In the Sahara Desert, Libya, Sudan, in such kind of a countries where agriculture is not possible, minerals are not found in such economies. That's why they are lagging behind. So this classification is not as authentic, not considered as in a larger scale. The HDI's classification is more considered in world economies because health and education, which is directly associated with the improving the capabilities of humans. If a person is healthy, if a person is educated, well educated, then it will contribute in economy by their full efficiency. If the person is healthy, it is educated, then to which it can improve their income. Clear? So India is a developing country. That's why we call India as a developing country. Yes, Japji? Japji, call.
Sir, what is the per capita income of India?
Average income, Japji. Average income. Hamari yahan teen age group mein log divided hain. People are generally divided into three parts. One as a 0 to 14 age group. Second is a 15 to 59, means working class, which can do the work. If a child is doing under the age group, belong from the under the age group of 15 years, this is as a illegal in our country. And third group is a 60 and above. So the population lies under the 15 and above over the 60. Above of the 60, they are the dependence class. They are dependent on a 15 to 59 age group. So income kaun earn kar raha hai 15 to the 59 age group are basically earning the salaries. Such salary has divided among the others, which lies under the age group of 15 to less or 60 to above. 60 to above. That's why the per capita income is lower in our country. The average income earned by all individuals. Clear? Japji?
Sir, China's economy is developed or developing?
Repeat, Daljeet.
Sir, China's income is developed or developing?
China is a developed country. China is a developed economy because they fully utilize their resources. Ek aur example hai, Japan. One example is Japan. In Japan, natural resources are not there. Agriculture is not possible in an island country. एग्रीकल्चर इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन आइलैंड कंट्री ऑफ जापान. जापान का अगर जियोलॉजिकल स्ट्रक्चर देखा जाए, जापान एवरी ईयर इट एक्सपीरियंस द सुनामीज. सुनामीज बिकॉज इट हैज लाइज ऑन यूरेशियन एंड पैसिफिक बेल्ट, मार्जिन ऑफ यूरेशियन एंड पैसिफिक बेल्ट. ठीक है, टेक्टोनिक बेल्ट के ऊपर, टेक्टोनिक प्लेट के ऊपर लोकेटेड है जापान. इन जापान मिनरल्स आर नॉट फाउंड बट स्टिल जापान इज अ डेवलप्ड इकोनॉमी. रीजन बिकॉज जापान 60% ऑफ अ गवर्नमेंट्स बजट, गवर्नमेंट के जितना पैसा है उसे 60% इट हैज डायरेक्टली कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट इन इंप्रूवमेंट्स ऑफ हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन. हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन. इसी के ऑपोजिट एक और कंट्री है पाकिस्तान, विच इज अंडर डेवलप्ड इकोनॉमी. यहां पर एग्रीकल्चर भी पॉसिबल है, मिनरल्स आर फाउंड इन पाकिस्तान, बट स्टिल पाकिस्तान इज अ अंडर डेवलप्ड इकोनॉमी. मीन्स दे आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन अदर्स, दे आर नॉट सेल्फ सफिशिएंट. पाकिस्तान इट स्टिल नॉट सेल्फ डेवलप्ड इटसेल्फ, इट स्टिल डिपेंडेंट ऑन अदर इकोनॉमीज. टिल इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ पाकिस्तान ऑन 14th अगस्त 1947 to 2007, it was dependent on America for the financial support. And later in stage, now it has dependent on China for the financial support. But India is a self-sufficient at their fields, but try to overcome their problems. That's why we call India as a developing country. India is a developing country. Japan is a fully developed their nation. And third, as a Pakistan is an underdeveloped economy. Clear? Underdeveloped economy. In economy, the total number of goods and services, whatever which are produced, these are calculated under the GDP. GDP. They are calculated under GDP. In economy, economic activities which contributes in economy for production of goods and services, these are used to calculate the GDP of a country. GDP indicates the developmental status of a country. Developmental status of a country. It stands for gross domestic product. Gross domestic product. Gross domestic product. Gross domestic product. It is the sum value of GDP is the sum value of GDP is the sum value of all the goods and services produced in country. GDP is the sum of the value of all the goods and services produced in economy. If the country's GDP is more than 15%, it indicates as their developmental status. More than 15 as a development. Clear? More than 15. The present day, India's GDP is in negative. Reason is because goods and services, these influence during the time period of the lockdowns. Almost all the countries of the world, their development, it influenced during the period of a lockdown because number of industries are there. We still not produce during that period. So GDP is a gross domestic product, which is the sum value of all goods and services produced in economy. Understood? Produce in economy. And second concept, which is related with this, is the GNP, gross national product. Gross national product. Gross national product. GNP stands for gross national product. So it has calculated, GNP calculated GNP, gross national product, is calculated with some value of goods and services, some of the value of all goods and services produced in economy, plus some value of all goods and services produced in economy with addition to income earned from abroad. Income earned from abroad through which we can calculate as a gross national product. Gross national product through which we can calculate gross national product means those number of individuals which are displaced from India towards other countries for the earning of their livelihoods. They gone in a Canada, America, Dubai, UAE, in a such countries for earn income. They earn the income in a such countries by production of goods and services, but spending on our country. They are spending such income in our country. That's why their income is also calculated under the GNP. GNP calculates with the sum of all the products, goods and services, some value of all the goods and services with inclusion of income earned from abroad. Income earned from abroad, because those persons which move towards other countries for their earnings on temporary basis, these are not permanently residing on such areas. After some span of 4, 5, 10 years, they are moving back towards their own country, towards India, for spending that money. They are our assets. Such population is our asset. Clear? Such population is our asset. They are contributing in national economy of a country. So through which we can calculate the gross national product. Till there, any doubts? Through which we can calculate the GNP, gross national product. With the name is clear, domestic means those goods which are produced within a boundaries of a country are the GDP. Those goods which are produced within a boundaries of a country plus income earned from abroad is a GNP, gross national product. Gross national product. Yes, Daljeet.
Sir, why individual would spend money?
Because their families are living in there. Daljeet, only the people which are working in other countries, they are gone towards such countries, but their families residing in India. Why do your parents, they are earn income because of the services providing to you. So they are earning the income in other countries, but spending such income in India, that's why they are our assets. They still are citizens, which are the assets of our country, with spending their income in our country. Clear? Through which we can calculate the GNP, gross national product. So this much for today. Any questions? So we covered this much today. So any of the questions? Nobody? So this much for today.